It's Presley at ActOutGames.com here, and today is Science Sunday, and we are going to be doing balloon science with Professor P. So at first we were going to do one balloon experiment, but then we realized that there are a lot of balloon experiments and we've done a lot of them and there are a lot of them that are really cool, so we decided that we're going to show you some of our favorites. Let's get started. So the first one is all about sound, because balloons are really good for experiments about sound. So all you need for this one is a couple of balloons and a coin or a hex nut or both. So what you have to do is then put your coin or your hex nut into a balloon and then tie it off and then spin it around and it will make a sound. So I'm gonna start spinning this one. Spin this quarter. We have a quarter on this one. That's the sound that it makes. So now let's listen to the small hex nut and see what it sounds like. It's weird, all the balloons are rolling around. That's what happens when you have lots of balloons. Okay, now for the larger hex nut. So now let's talk about why they all sound different. So the reason it makes sound is because these hex nuts aren't perfectly round. So when I hit the hex, when I roll the hex nut on the table, it makes this clicking sound. So it's doing the exact same in the balloon, except that you're spinning it so it's going a lot faster. So the length apart of the hits on the side of the balloon determined the pitch of the sound. So when you spin the quarter around, there are grooves that are really, really close together, so it makes a super high pitched sound. And when you spin the small hex nut, it makes a lower pitch sound, but it's still pretty high pitched. But when you spin the large hex nut, it makes a even lower pitch sound than the small hex nut. So that is why it makes the sounds, and you can determine the pitch as well by how fast you spin the balloon. So when you spin the balloon faster, the edges will hit the sides faster, so sides of the balloon faster, so it will make a higher pitch sound the more you spin it, the faster you spin it. So that's why the speed of the balloon determines the sound as well, the pitch of the sound as well. Another way you can experiment with the sound with balloons is by popping it. So it's kept, in my case, the experiment with sound is my screaming as well as the popping of the balloon. So let's try and pop this one. So we've all heard balloons pop, but have you ever wondered why it makes a sound when it pops? So what's happening here is there's a lot of high pressure air in the balloon. And like we talked about the other day, high pressure fluids will move into low pressure fluids. And when we pop the balloon, the high pressure fluid can suddenly get out, but it can't when it's inside the balloon because, well, it's inside of a balloon. So when it gets out of the balloon, it immediately rushes into the low pressure air, and that creates like a shockwave, and we hear that, but it doesn't actually do it perfectly. So the air goes a little too fast, and then it leaves some low pressure over here, so it tries to go back into that, and then it starts moving back and forth, and it creates a vibration, which we also hear. And the pitch of the sound is really determined by the size of the balloon, because the shockwave will be bigger the bigger the balloon. So like when we popped that balloon, it was a higher pressure sound, a higher pitch sound than it would be if we popped an exercise ball. Because this whole going back and forth and the vibration will be slower with the big exercise ball, that's why the pitch is lower. So another balloon, this is a balloon demonstration that demonstrates the really cool properties of water. So water is one of my favorite things in the universe. I would have said on Earth, but they found water other places, so I'm not just going to say on Earth. So it's super duper cool. So if I take a match and I put it under this balloon, it goes pop. The rubber will melt and it goes pop. I can get the match to work. It will pop. Okay, I didn't scream that time, which is good. So we're going to do the exact same thing, except I'm going to use a balloon with a little bit of water in it. It's not popping. So the reason it does that is because water is so good at absorbing heat, this balloon won't pop until all this water evaporates. So even if you do another and another and another match, then it will keep absorbing the heat and the balloon will not pop, which is super cool. So we've shown you experiments with sound and experiments with water, and we pop the water balloons doing those. But now we're gonna try and do the opposite and not pop a balloon while sticking a skewer through it. I'm really nervous because I don't like the sound of the balloon popping, but I'm gonna try and see what happens. Let's stick the skewer through here. Ooh, I got through that pretty fast. Okay, faster than I expected to get it through with my extreme nervousness about doing this experiment. Oh, I hear air coming out of it. Don't come out fast, okay? If you don't come out fast, then I'll be fine. I did it! That scared me. Okay, let's take it out. It didn't pop still. Now the air is just going to eventually get out of that balloon. So let's talk about why that happened. When you blow up a balloon, it expands, obviously. So, but it doesn't expand uniformly. Some parts of the balloon expand more than others. So here on this balloon, we took Sharpie and we made Sharpie marks going all around the balloon, and some near where you blow it up and one on the very end and some around the middle. And we are going to blow this up and see the comparison from where it is now to where it is when it's blown up. Now that it's blown up, you can see that the dots on the side have really expanded and they've gotten thinner and the ink has gotten fainter because, well, the balloon has expanded and it's gotten thicker, but thinner. And the one on the top and the one on the very bottom have, the ones on the very bottom and the one on the top have barely changed at all. So it's thicker there, less deformed, and is under a lot less pressure. So if you stick a skewer through here and here, it's okay and it won't pop. But if you stick skewer through any of these thin places, it will pop, and I'm about to do that. Prepare for screams. Okay, I didn't scream that time, that's good. So those were a few really, really cool balloon experiments. If you have a birthday party, definitely do some of these and teach some science while you're doing a birthday party, which I'm going to do at my birthday party. So do that. I hope you really enjoyed these. If you have balloons laying around your house from the last birthday party or for any reason at all, definitely use those instead. Use those too. So just have a bunch of fun with these experiments because they're super cool. So yeah, thank you for watching. And next tomorrow.